houses, new classes, new peers, new school. School. Everybody, whether they have siblings waiting for them or not, is walking into the unknown. We may know some of the teachers' names and are experts on the tricks that are usually played on incoming freshmen. Third floor, and the gym is not next to the swimming pool. But none of us have ever been in high school before. So here's my advice to you. Our whiteboards are not clean. Sure, it may feel like it, but it can never be taken away. That's good. And if you remember those things, I think you'll be okay. I know I have learned a lot in just the last year alone. First of all, I would say, be brave. There are going to be situations in high school where you wish you could just sink right into the floor. But don't. Swallow your fear, stand tall, and tell yourself, I am going to do this. It may not be true, but if you let that fear win, you'll miss chance after chance. I read a quote on the wall next to the harbor staircase the other day. It says, courage is resistance to fear, mastery of fear, not absence of fear. That quote really hit home for me because there have been dozens of times in my life when fear has dictated the outcome of something, whether I did well or not. This is one of the things that I have learned in gym class. You know that point around fifth grade where gym turns from running around and playing games the whole time to that tweeny version where you have to change in the locker rooms and run laps? It was around that time that I signed up for volleyball. Everyone else was much better than me, and I spent more time trying not to look like a dweeb than on improving my skills. Eventually, though, I realized that if I wanted to get better at volleyball, I was going to have to focus on improvement and nothing else. After that, I can proudly say, I still stunk. But at least I was focused and I did improve faster than before. Once I had swallowed my fear, I could focus on my goal. Another thing that I have learned from WCS is that a little bit of humor or kindness can go a long way. The smallest moment can make the biggest impact. For my last 2 years at WCS, I was a ski instructor at Cochran's every Friday. During my second year as an instructor, we faced a particularly icy day, and kids were slipping and sliding like little Eskimos covered in gravy. It had been a long day, and I had already pulled a kid up from a near split dozens of times, and had done a painful split myself while trying to keep a student from sliding into the line of skiers who were being pulled up the mountain. A student was skiing down the mountain with me when she fell into a split position. I positioned myself in front of her and braced her so she wouldn't go sliding down the mountain like a rogue gymnast. Her panic-stricken voice wavered as she looked into my eyes on the verge of tears. "Ow," she said. I remember wondering for a moment what to say, and then I replied, "Well, at least you'll be more flexible now." It was a lame joke and only managed to coax a feeble laugh, but it had done the trick. The panic had vanished and was replaced by a teetering unsureness. My simple and lame little joke had changed the whole situation. Could the situation really be that dire if I was still cracking jokes? Honestly, that was one of my favorite teaching moments that I can recall. Another time that I witnessed a small act turn into something bigger was an absolutely awful day for me in fifth grade. I was having some troubles adjusting to the new house. I spent first grade through fourth in kaleidoscope. That was before they moved the grade limit. And I was so upset I couldn't muster enough bravery to go to any of my classes. I didn't know anybody. Teacher after teacher had tried to coax me into going, but I just wouldn't do it. Eventually, Miss Peterson walked up to me and offered to take me on a walk to calm down, and of course, I accepted. After three quarters through the lap, she opened her mouth to speak. For a moment, I attempted to brace myself the inevitable speech on the importance of classes. But that's not what she said at all. Instead, she told me a story from when she worked with younger students, about one of them who had brought in a guitar to show and tell and started singing while strumming it. I knew the student she was speaking of as a friend, and so I found this even more amusing. After that, I felt tremendously better. Big shout out to Miss Peterson. I still remember that, and I still appreciate it to this day. She didn't force me to do anything, just talked and gave me a good laugh. Sometimes that's all you need. I have learned from teachers and fellow students throughout my Williston experience that kindness, even the smallest act, can have such a huge impact, it can affect someone for the rest of their lives. Those are just two of the things that I have learned from my experience at Williston Central School. I've learned forever about it, until most of you are gazing off into space, dreaming about me with duct tape over my mouth. And the only ones who are listening are my loyal friends, who'd better be listening. But I would like to avoid stripping duct tape off my face tonight. So as a wrap-up, I would like to say to my fellow 8th graders, no matter how you feel about going into high school, remember the things you have learned from middle school. Not simple things like 1 plus 1 equals 2, although that is helpful. How are you supposed to become a rocket scientist or a doctor if you can't tell that one chocolate chip cookie plus another cookie equals 2 cookies? Anyway, remember the things that no matter what faces you in high school, always push boundaries every single day, and to know that every person you come across, whether they are a fellow freshman or a senior, they are facing their own challenges, just like everyone else. We all make an impact in the world, and it is our choice what we want that impact to be. Somebody is looking to us, whether we know it or not, so go out there every day and be the person you want to be. Do your best and forget the rest. You want to do something? Stay positive and give it a go. Big shout outs to all the teachers at WCS. You have made my time here amazing and have taught me much more than just the bare basics. And I was thinking. I will truly miss you all and hope that you continue to fill this school with the fun and passion you always have. Although I'm extremely sad to leave Williston Central, I look forward to what's ahead. As a great internet scholar, Google Images, said, let go of the things you can't change and focus on the things you can. The great thing about a whiteboard is that you can select what you want to erase. If there's something you didn't like from middle school, erase it. If there's something that you are hanging on to from middle school, erase it. If you have regrets from middle school, erase it. Every day is a chance to become the person you want to be. Every person here can wake up in the morning and say, this is the day I'm going to change it. Change may not come easy, but you have the power to make that change. Believe in yourself and be brave. Like I said before, courage is resistance to fear, mastery of fear, not absence of fear. Although I wish I could stay here a little longer, I don't see myself getting any younger anytime soon. So might as well stay positive, right? Unless you've got a spare time machine laying around. In that case, you can hook me up. Thank you.
But one thing's for sure, we've all grown a lot. Ask your parents to recognize yourself. Let me start this off with a tough admission, one that, despite constant reminder from my older brothers, I was not able to come to terms with until recently. I was quite an irritating fifth grader. In fact, I thought I was the coolest of the cool, and after a little bit of reflection, I'll admit I was absolutely not. Now I bet some of you are thinking, all right, so you were annoying, but what does admitting that have to do with being ready for high school? Well, I'll tell you. For one thing, it lets me know that I have changed and grown. It lets me know that I am no longer the spunky fifth grader who never left the older kids alone, and that I now have a better grasp of social cues. However, the biggest reason that this admission makes me feel like I am prepared is that when I think back on myself from that time, and I imagine the rather spirited young girl I was, I realized that even if I could go back in time, I probably, first of all, still couldn't convince her she wasn't cool. And to be honest, whether or not I could go back and change myself wouldn't make a difference. No matter what my options may be, my choice will remain the same. To leave the fiery little girl with the mostly pure intentions alone. Because growing up happens through experience. It happens through annoying behavior and stupid mistakes and even amazing accomplishments. Accomplishments like giving a speech at my 8th grade graduation, or mistakes like waiting till the night of an open house to start my visual model. To tell you the truth, I think I've pretty much covered the gamut of annoying behavior. But all those things are irrelevant. I don't need to tell you about them. I have something much better than an example or a story. I have the end result. Hi, I'm Alex Akey. And the me standing here today giving this speech is the end result. Well, not the end, but the end for now. It is because of my mistakes, my flaws, and my accomplishments that I am this version of myself today. I confess I did not get here on my own. I had support from incredible people like Kevin Hunt, the best core teacher I could have ever asked for. I'm going to take this second to say thank you to him for an amazing 3 years. I am not perfect, not even close. I am flawed, and I know for a fact that I can still be annoying. But I am ready. That in itself is something I see as an accomplishment. An accomplishment for me, my teachers, my parents, and even for the school. I can undoubtedly say that the majority of people in this room have heard the phrase, with mistakes comes learning through this place, is that that is exactly right. I hope that all of my fellow classmates will find their reason to be ready. It may be personal growth, like it was for me, or maybe it will be through academic achievement, or maybe something totally different. But regardless of what it is, when you find it, you will be ready too. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Parker Soares. Hello, 8th graders, teachers, staff, and parents. Throughout my time here in Williston School District, I have learned many things, both through my studies and through my friends and family. All of what happened throughout my years has shaped my current personality and the way I learn. Some of my most memorable moments have happened within these walls. I'm sure many others can say the same. The inspiring words of my teacher, support from friends, and fellow students have strengthened my learning experience. By being in this sort of environment has allowed me to be successful in my subjects, prepare me for high school, and even beyond that. My friendships formed in the schools have allowed me to see all different kinds of people. Of all the people, I look upon a few and realize just how important they have been during these years in Williston. I look upon my poor teacher with respect for all that she has taught me, and a good friend for always being there and always being supportive when things were rough. I have found the majority of my interest and hobby through this school and the school's programs. I look back to moments that have changed the way I thought about the world and how to see things from a different perspective. I once believed that the world was a small place, only a little planet in this vast universe. Through my studies, I see just how big this world is and all the opportunities available. As I continued through my grades, my understanding of the world, both locally and globally, grew, and I realized just how important every person on this planet really is, and how everyone can make an impact. In my class, we have had a read aloud. In the book, The Five People You Meet in Heaven, I distinctly remember one quote. Every person meets someone who changes them. Sometimes they change you. This really stood out to me, and I pondered that quote for the rest of the day. I realized just how true that statement is, and how important it is to keep those who matter close. The quote reminded me of one of my friends, as he has a personality that I rarely see. His kindness was toward everybody, even if they didn't like him or were rude to him. I saw how impactful this quality was, and I wanted to be like that. I also remember when I asked my mother in fourth grade, do I have enough friends? Her response was, it's not how many friends you have, but how true your relationship is with them. When I met him, that was exactly what I thought about. Another time that greatly stood out to me is my connection with other students in fifth grade. I was just entering fifth grade, and I wasn't sure what to expect yet. Before I even grew comfortable with my teachers, I became connected to peers. I had a few classmates in my third and fourth grade house. I would play with a few friends who were from the same house as me at recess, and slowly got to know the other peers. When I met most of the friends I know now, I remember how clearly different they all acted from each other. They filled in each other's weaknesses with their strengths, and they enjoyed how different they were. I was surprised, because I always thought their best friends had the most in common. After being with them, the longer they were together, the more similar that they grew. All of my experiences here have changed my outlook and showed me so much more than I thought possible in middle school. These moments and memories are what make me believe what I do now, Thank you.
Thank you.
Ashley Davidson. Every year, WCS dedicates a yearbook to someone special within our community. I am honored to say I am a former student of this amazing woman. This year's 2015-2016 yearbook is dedicated to Deborah Montini. Would John Montini please come forward then? Our dear friend Deborah Lentini was a longtime teacher at Williston Schools. She was someone who thoroughly enjoyed life. Deborah could be found carving the snow on her snowboard, paddling with her drag boat team, walking through the woods with her dogs, reading a good book, listening to classic rock, and sharing laughter with her friends and family. She made us better teachers and better people with her wisdom and zen-like attitude. We will miss her greatly, but we're very fortunate to have her in our lives. To Deborah.
Tonight, I am honored to present the glimpses of beloved design and technology to the 70s and 80s. And tragically, he died from cancer at the young age of 29. Gordon Jones was a young man who we here have loved life, teaching, and photography. His family set up a fund in his honor to purchase a gift for one deserving 8th grade student. In tribute to his love of photography, the award began as a 35mm camera. And as technology evolved, the award has too. Over my career here, I have seen the award evolve from the 35mm camera, to a digital camera, to an iPod, to an iPad, and now it's a Chromebook. This award is given to an 8th grader who has participated in all related arts classes of art, music, Design and Technology, Family and Consumer Science, and Physical Education with enthusiasm, effort, and engagement. All related arts teachers collaborate and choose the student they believe best fits these characteristics. The student who earned the award this year easily meets these qualifications. For years, he's entered the band room with a swift stride and a bright smile, his genuine happiness and enthusiasm so apparent. His exuberant and unwavering good morning upon arrival brightened my early mornings for the past few years. He is a confident leader, he's kind to all, and he is so sincere in his actions to help anyone whenever he detects a need. I am not at all surprised that he showed these qualities and contributed positively throughout all areas of related arts. I am proud to present this year's Gordon Jones Award to a true gentleman, Ryan Underhill.
This is the Al Meyer Spirit of Williston Award. Spirit of Williston Award was established by the Student Council in 1991, 10 years before these students were born. Since that time, 105 Williston 8th graders have received the award. Tonight, five more names will be added to the roster. The award is given to one 8th grader from each house who best exemplifies concern and caring for others by volunteering his or her time in service to the school and others, fostering goodwill, encouraging school pride and spirit, and contributing significantly to the school's atmosphere. The faculty and staff members in each house determine the recipient of the award. The award has been renamed the Alan S. Meyer Spirit of Williston Award in honor of Al's many contributions and accomplishments that set a high standard for the faculty, staff, and students of the Williston School District. The teachers presenting this evening, in this order, hopefully, Tracy Tobin from Full House, Andrea Griffin and Jess Kramer from Harbor House, Kevin Hunt from Swift House, and Martha Quatt from Voyager House. Tracy Tobin.
Tracy, not Chris. Sorry to throw you all off. The Spirit of Williston Award is an award that, as a house, we always struggle with every year because the eighth graders that we have for 4 years, you just get to know them forward and backwards. But the Spirit of Williston Award this year embodies many of the attributes that we look for in successful young people. This is a person who is intellectually curious, always positive, accepts everyone, and above all, this person is kind. This individual has a unique ability to navigate the social highs and lows of middle school life with flair. This person is a constant beacon of positive energy. He or she is incredibly friendly and accepting of all students. This person socializes with everyone, and because of this, is admired by all ages on the team. However, this person isn't just an incredible addition to our team. Everywhere this person goes, she leaves a positive impression. At Williston Central School, she brought joys to others by helping out with the Dancerama. And for her eighth grade challenge, she created a fundraiser to help people who are struggling with breast cancer. She is also a team player and an incredible athlete. She is a talented gymnast and a dominant player on the basketball court. In fact, I don't think I saw a player smile more while playing in the student-faculty basketball game, but that might have been because her skill was superior to all of the faculty. As someone who has had the pleasure of getting to know this young lady over the past 4 years and to see her incredible growth as a person, I strongly suggest anyone who doesn't know her to take the time to do so. You won't be disappointed. It is my honor and my pleasure to present the Spirit of Williston Award to McKenna Boyd.
Experience, and then thanked her for taking him once they met up with the other group. A different teacher remembers a time during science class. They were testing the law of inertia, so they were pushing a rolling chair with books stacked on it toward a recycling bin. The chair was supposed to hit the bin and stop while the books slid forward into the bin. Well, this bin's aim must have been so much force that the books slid right into the wall, knocking a hole right through the sheetrock. He felt terrible the next day without any prompting, appeared in her class with a putty and a spackling knife with the intention of repairing the damage he had accidentally done to the wall. The class act indeed. Just last year, the student spent time on one of his days each week to meet with upcoming Swifty in order to help establish a relationship and help the new Swift students transition to middle school. Personally, I've had the opportunity to work with the student both in the classroom and on the lacrosse field, and I can tell you that his kindness, hard work ethic, and good nature follow him wherever he goes, regardless of whose company he's in. I am proud to present this year's Spirit Williston Award to Bobby Spencer.
Good evening, my name is Martha Watt, and I'm a member of Will Is an Adventure. There's no place where you can find such extreme levels of emotion, hormones, and intense intellectual curiosity all rolled up into a crazy space called middle school. When I asked students to describe middle school, this is what they said. Middle school is a start to something, torturous, fun, social, long. A time to make relationships. Like a drama bus. Would be better without homework. Hard but worth it. It was a fun time, but it's time to move on. When you find a student that is able to navigate this journey with integrity, pluck, and humanity, everyone sits up and takes notice. Our Voyager Spirit Award recipient is empathetic, intelligent, caring, thoughtful, accepting of others, and always willing to go the extra mile without complaint. She is a leader, a musician, an athlete, and a die-hard hockey fan. It gives me great pleasure and honor to present the Spirit Williston Award to Kylie McClure.
A little bit. People have been giving their speech and they kind of tease a little bit who the recipient award winner is. I'm just going to spill my guts right at the beginning, and I'm just going to ask the recipient to just stay in your seat until the end. So Al Myers is a Williston Central School legend. His name is synonymous with quality, passion for learning, and for history. It appears on the walls of our theater, on certificates of middle level, and on so many of our student awards here at Williston Central School. Al believed in hard work and taking the time to do things well. Al would be very pleased to know that the recipient of this year's Al Myers Spirit of History Award is James Eustace. James has grown in so many ways during his 4 years at Full House physically. He now stands more than 6 feet, 2 inches tall. His sense of humor has developed just as much and is a favorite of his peers and teachers. As a student, James has learned that grit and perseverance will take him as far as he wants to go. James' thirst for knowledge about social studies topics ranging from North Korea, U.S. presidents, U.S. history, and electoral politics is evident almost every day. He's worked this year in humanities class developing expertise on the status of North Korea and its role amongst countries in Asia and the world. James is an almost unbelievable source of information on U.S. presidents. All of the students in Full House, when they're working on research about U.S. presidents, will seek James out, and they will cite him
in the bibliography. Last year, as a seventh grader, James Project on Nazi Germany studied the relationship between the different Axis countries and Hitler's rise to power. This year, James is really enjoying the theater of the U.S. presidential election and can be overheard along with Full House, helping to inform his peers about the status of the primaries and the different candidates. Please join me in welcoming James Eustace to the podium to receive this year's Alumni.
To the teacher, that's an avid reader too. Our award recipient recommended the Martian to me so enthusiastically throughout his middle school years. The student right, that comes with avid reader. In class discussions, our recipient is always ready to share current event connections, creating a contagious intellectual atmosphere. When a student has to be stopped 12 pages into their narrative writing piece, that too signals an avid reader. Our recipient transfers his enthusiasm for reading into writing his own twisting plots, which embody the humor from his favorite authors. Finally, when the youth librarian at the Dorothy Allen Library says, and I quote, "I would love to share a few words about him," you know you're dealing with a truly avid reader. She went on to say, "He is a force of nature when it comes to reading. He absorbs words in books in a way rarely seen in someone his age, or for any age for that matter. His spontaneous enthusiasm of his favorite books spills over to his peers, who often look to him for reading recommendations. I am completely certain that his excitement and energy for reading will continue into his years at CPU." End quote. So, from us here at WCS and the librarians at Dorothy Hunting Library, best wishes and congratulations to Eric Kuchar.
And I also teach French and Spanish here. and we're here tonight to present the World Language Excellence Awards.
It was very difficult for us. We actually labored a lot because this year's eighth graders are fabulous in so many ways. They're some of the strongest that we've had in years in terms of both academics and just humanity. Very kind, very enthusiastic, and really exemplify the growth mindset. We have three recipients this year, and they're outstanding in all of the following areas.
As Deb said, they excel
consistently, go above and beyond.
They're engaged, enthusiastic language learners.
They all have exceptional work habits.
A positive attitude.
Example.
They show an inquisitiveness and dedication to language learning.
We will ask the recipients to come up to receive their awards. Please hold your applause until we read all of the names.
Congratulations to Camille Menard, Lily Mahalik, and Adam Zukowski. Sterling House, and I teach a math class. Alexandra Akey. Jacob Allaire. Baker Engsma. Brianna Baczynski. Lainey Baker. Duchesne.
Hiller.
Brendan Lee Prevost.
Haley Materno. Shreyas Malotra. Blaine Martin. Claire McDevitt. Connor McDevitt. Rory McNeil. Anthony Nguyen. Kimberly Nguyen. Gage Nolte. Thank you. Robert Spencer. Shelby Stack. Olivia Yando.